I'm Sarah Collins Simmons. I'm with Future Generations University. I want to show you our rocket stove sap evaporator today. I'm going to show you what it looks like and then how we operate it. So I've got this cover on here to keep the barrel dry. And so inside is what we call the chimney, and that's got our firebox in it. And then we've got this part, which is our flame spreader, and that's part of what makes it a rocket stove. The flames actually come out of here and then go back down into the exhaust, and so we get a reburn that way. I'm gonna put our barrel lid, which has a cutout for our evaporator, and then the fire rope to help kind of seal it for a gasket. And we just place that in place when we put the evaporator in, and or the pan in, and then we'll set our evaporator pan, which is a 30 quart stainless steel brazier pan. So that's what we'll be evaporating sap out of. And then we'll go ahead and get started and light a fire and show you how this works.
So this is our ash pan. This is the door to seal off the airflow from it. We've got a grate up in our firebox, and then it lets the ashes fall out. And so this makes our clean out real easy. When we're firing it, we close the little door on it.
All right, we're ready to get started. So I'm going to start by taking off this wood chute. When we're actually firing the evaporator, it makes it easier to feed the fire. But to get started, it's nice to have access to my kindling and wood. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some sap to my pan so that I don't scald the pan before we get, once we get the fire started. And we'll go ahead and fire up. The next step is to go ahead and start the fire, and I'm going to use a torch to make it quick and easy.
Let's see if that'll catch. I don't think we'll have any problem.
Now that the fire's caught, my wood's caught, I'm gonna go ahead and put this wood chute back in and start feeding the fire. Got a little smoke coming out, so I'm gonna tighten up my fire rope a little bit. Yeah, we're 7 minutes in, and we're starting to get some steam.
Lots of steam now. Starting to see some bubbles.
All right, we're about 12 minutes in. We're getting a lot of steam coming off. The barrel's getting hot, and we have a real boil. We are evaporating sap. We're making maple syrup. Now that we've got a really rolling boil, I'm gonna go ahead and take the lid off and let it steam and evaporate into syrup. So sometimes you have to troubleshoot if your fire isn't really rolling and pulling, you're getting backfire. So we've tuned our rocket stove with these pieces of angle iron. We've lifted the pan up about an inch off that fire spreader. So we're gonna show you what happens if you don't have that. We've got some smoke coming back out and we're starting to get some back pressure here. You don't want smoke coming out of your wood chute, out of your firebox. It's not drawing right. So we're losing, our exhaust is actually getting colored to it where it was burning clean before. We're getting smoke coming back out of our firebox. And now we're gonna tune it by lifting it back up. And you can really just see it suck back up. As you can see, we've lifted our pan back up and our fire is drawing well again. The flames are pulling back in and we've got clean exhaust again. Come on back and watch part two of our rocket stove sap evaporator videos and learn how to build one of these for yourself.